ಸಂಗೀತಂ ಮಧುರಂ ಹೃದಯಂ ಮಧುರಂ ಗಮನಂ ಮಧುರಂ ಮಥುರಾಧಿಪತೆ ಅಖಿಲಂ
about something, time is not of consequence. The word passion itself denotes the idea that you will automatically find the time, and from it will stem the idea of perseverance and dedication. Merely wanting something is not the same as doing it and pursuing it actively, and I think this applies for anything that you do. Along with passion comes the idea of diligence or perseverance. Now, what is diligence? Or in many words, is that diligence is the idea that you constantly, thoughtfully persevere and repeatedly do something. In an art world or in a performing art world, I'll speak for artists and dancers and musicians, and I think it holds good for anything else that you do, is the idea that you find some way or any way to get better at what you do. It might be that you wake up early in the morning. It might be that you stay up late at night. Might be that you have to do the same thing over and over a million times. But then the idea is that you want to get better at what you do. So you repeatedly do it again and again. I've read recently and I've heard in many ways in from different people that by repeating these things, it also has a psychological impact, for which I leave you to science to read about it. But this is something I think that artists have been doing. We repeat something. We repeat the same step every day, again and again and again, without ever tiring of it. So much so that this step or this movement or this idea becomes a habit. A habit so much so that you don't need to think about it and you can execute it with articulation and with clarity without having to think about it, without telling your hands or telling your legs or telling your eyes where to go. You know how to take the light, you know where the audience is, you know where to face, you know there's a certain aesthetic when it comes to Bharatanatyam. And I'm sure that's the same thing for tennis players or basketball players or anybody else, or gymnasts. How is it that a gymnast balances on a thin pole and does her handstands or his handstands and his front flips and back flips? I'm sure they're not thinking about it. It's just that they've done it so many times that their body automatically knows where to go. You don't have time to think and then execute it. And I think that idea of repeated perseverance can be applied to any field. What happens when you repeat something so many times is that there's no thought before the action. It just happens. It's almost second nature and it becomes a kind of it's an impulse. And you automatically do it because your body and your mind is trained to do it. And I think it can apply to the sciences or everything else. Now this diligence, so when you repeatedly do this, when you repeatedly train yourself and do it again and again and again, over and over, what happens is that people think that you're talented. So this idea of talent or inclination, yes, it exists, but it's a very small percentage. And very often people say, oh, you're so talented at dancing. And I feel like laughing because I think talent in reality is a myth. It's not even real. Because I'm quite sure that almost all the dancers that I know who are excellent have persevered and have been diligent. They've been diligent about their practice and about repeating again and again what they already know. So this manifests itself in what we think of as talent. So we say, oh, she's so talented at singing, but we don't know that she wakes up every day at 3 a.m. and conditions her voice every day, repeatedly, for hours and hours and hours. And when you see her perform on stage, or when you hear her sing, you say, oh, you're so talented. But actually, it's not just her talent. Her talent is a very small percentage. I see this even with my small children. I train a lot of little children and they're very tiny. When you start young, what happens is that it's not just that the body is more malleable and your mind is more, apt at receiving new ideas and thoughts when you're young. It's just that you also have a lot more time. You have a lot more time. So when you start young, when you start at 6, or 5, or 4, or 7, what happens is that by the time you're 17, you've already had 10 years of practice. That's 10 years more than someone who starts at 17. And they've repeated things so many times that it's already become second nature in their bodies. So when people say, can you start something later? Yes, maybe you can, but you have to make up for those 10 years of hours that somebody else has put in from 7 to 17. And that's the truth of it. And if you're able to make it up, obviously it'll work out. But now this idea that we manifest as talent, when someone becomes really talented and they are very good at what they do, we say, oh, they're very successful. And what do we think of as success in our society today? Now see what we are terming as success socially. These are all goals. And where then is the room for passion? In reality, your success is within, when you keep your success within the gamut of your own passion. Let's say you are passionate about engineering, about the way machines work. You are passionate about designing houses, or you are absolutely love, I don't know, predicting financial markets. Okay? Now, success is in the small things within that passion. For me as a dancer, success is going that half inch lower and holding it for 2 seconds longer with stillness. It's being able to hold myself out in the last piece of that 90 minutes. The previous performance, which I let go of at 87, I want to hold it out till 89 minutes. That is success. For the runner, if he reaches that 100 meters at 0.2 seconds faster, that is success. And I think, I don't know these other professions as well, but I think that for someone who works in finance or in thing, predicting that market exactly to that single cent or paisa or rupee, that is success. All the other things are fallouts of your success. They are the fallouts. Becoming an entrepreneur, being famous, performing in front of 1,000 people, these are fallouts of your real success. Your real success is within what you are passionate about. It's within your area of work, within what you think you like and love to do with your life. Because the other goals in reality are ephemeral, because if you become an entrepreneur, then what? You become successful. The rest of your life becomes pointless. If I say, oh, I've become famous, and then what? Now I'm famous. So what then? After that? Your passion is dead. What you wanted to do, what will you do with your life? So if you reach this tangible, ephemeral goal, then your passion almost just dies. It's important to keep what you believe in and what you love alive within you. So when people ask me, how do you motivate yourself? How do you get up? How do you practice every day? I don't know. Actually, I don't motivate myself. I just have to practice every day. I have to get up. I have to do it again and again. Because I feel I need to get that better. I have to do better. I have to find something new within my dance, new within the area of what I love and I am, you know, inclined towards and have worked towards. So it's important to find the what you love and what you feel you are passionate about, or find that passion within the work that you do and do it again and again and again, and find every way that you can to get better at what you do, because then you're never good enough. And if you're never good enough, you'll never be satisfied, and the small successes will be the ones that keep pushing you forward. And at every point that you have a small success, it'll make you want to feel that small success again and again. And the big successes, the large ones which society perceives as success, don't really matter. They're just there and they're a part of your life. They come, they may come, they may not come, but still you have a sense of what you really want to do. Thank you.